Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Mohammed Youssef. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa made a statement in which he expressed his appreciation for the people of Bahrain as they contribute to generously to fight against COVID-19. His Royal Highness affirmed that the people of Bahrain have represented the kingdom to the world in the best possible light through their keen interest in protecting one another and protecting the country at large. He said that the medical personnel are subjecting themselves to great risks by working around the hour to keep Bahrain safe, and said that this is also true to those who work at the Ministries of Interior, Information Affairs, Education, Transportation and Telecommunications, the BDF and other national bodies. He said that he was committed to treatment abroad and has been self-quarantined upon arrival and worked remotely from home. He added that these instructions are necessary for all to be followed in order to overcome the virus. His Royal Highness said that this is a humanitarian crisis that is testing the scientific and medical progress of all nations, as well as their economic development and the awareness of their people. He added that investing in human capital is the most worthwhile investment, as the Bahraini example demonstrates. He concluded by saying that these hopes are not limited to slogans, but are reflected by the reality on the ground through the generosity and sacrifice of the people of Bahrain. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa chaired a meeting of the Government Executive Committee held remotely. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince highlighted the importance of further strengthening precautionary measures to mitigate the spread of the coronavirus and safeguard the health of citizens and residents. On this note, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince directed the Ministry of Interior, the Ministry of Labour and Social Development, and the Ministry of Labour Market Regulatory Authority to ensure precautionary guidelines in place for expatriate workers are being implemented across the kingdom. His Royal Highness reiterated the importance of reducing the number of workers within dormitories and ensuring social distancing measures are followed within transportation buses allocated for commuting employees to and from work. His Royal Highness further stressed the importance of assigning a specific work location for each worker and ensuring the workers wear face masks at all time. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince urged all enterprises protect their expatriate workers and demonstrate in dormitories by implementing necessary precautionary measures in accordance to Decision No. 40 for the year of 2014 issued by the Minister of Labour and Social Development. Additionally, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince extended his gratitude to all who have provided monetary and material support to national efforts aimed at mitigating the spread of the virus, particularly those who have contributed by providing additional accommodation to be used as dormitories, which is helping to reduce the density of expatriate workers at their residences. In this regard, His Royal Highness paid special thanks to Samha Holding, Sheikh Salman bin Ali Al Khalifa, Samir Abdullah Nas, Muhammad bin Ishaq Group, Warehousing Solutions, Tajdeed Cultural and Social Society, Namal Contracting and Trading, Sayyid Ali Habib Ali Hassan, Jamal Shwaitar Suites, and Shubra Ready Made Garment Company. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince further directed the Ministry of Industry, Commerce and Tourism to increase inspections across enterprises, shopping malls, and manufacturing facilities to ensure precautionary health guidelines and social distancing measures are being implemented, emphasizing that legal action will be taken against the violators. The representative of His Majesty the King for Humanitarian and Youth Affairs, National Security Advisor and Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, issued an edict restructuring the Coordination, Implementation and Follow-up Committee of Istijaba. Under the edict, the First Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, will be Chairman of the Committee, and His Highness Sheikh Faisal bin Rashid Al Khalifa will be its Deputy Chairman. The edict crowns the tremendous efforts exerted by His Highness Sheikh Khalid to develop the youth and sports sector in accordance with the directives of His Highness Sheikh Nasser to implement the goals of Istijaba as a national program that emanates from His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa's reform project and the vision of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa within the Economic Vision 2030. Members of the committee include Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa, Aymal Mu'ayyad, Abdullah Jihad Al-Zain, Dr. Abdurrahman Askar, Muhammad Al-Nusuf, and Muhammad Al-Ajmi. His Highness Sheikh Nasser directed the committee to give priority to creating an integrated system that brings together all the relevant sport parties to enhance cooperation among them, discuss work mechanisms, and implement joint development projects that would ensure the continuous development of the youth and sports movement in the kingdom. In line with His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa's directives and the endeavors of the cabinet chaired by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa and the efforts of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, National Security Advisor, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and Chairman of the Royal Humanitarian Foundation's Board of Trustees, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, announced donating 1 million Bahraini dinars from his personal account to support Bahrain's national campaign to combat the coronavirus. His Highness Sheikh Nasser made the announcement on his personal Instagram account to boost the There Is Good In Us campaign, which has been launched by His Highness to encourage all organizations and institutions to play a role in combating the virus. His Highness stated that this donation comes to bolster Bahrain's noble efforts to combat the virus. He stated that the There Is Good In Us campaign is in line with His Royal Highness the Crown Prince's vision to boost the national economy. He added that contributing to the campaign represents a national duty for everyone to combat the virus and safeguard the national and well-being of all citizens and residents. He asserted his keenness to avoid any negative impact on the economy, which will remain in its natural position as a result of the wise vision of His Majesty the King. He expressed sincere thanks and appreciation for the efforts exerted by the government to combat the pandemic and his keenness to provide all the necessary support to all medical teams. He hailed all the contributions to the campaign, which witnessed a large turnout from companies and public and private institutions.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. في هالوقت القصير هذا أرجوكم أنكم تسمحوا لي أني أقضي هالفترة البسيطة وأشرح لكم شيء كبير جدا. ما أدري أنا كيف بوفي المعلومة وكيف أني بوصل المعلومة، ولكن الفهيم راح يفهم والبخيص راح يبخص والمحب راح يتفهم. والموضوع هو طبعا حملة فينا خير. حملة فينا خير هذه مثل ما يقول الكتاب من عنوانه. اليوم هو يوم اللي الوطن اللي ربينا فيه واللي كلينا من خيره واللي عشنا في ذراه وعشنا في ظل قيادته الرشيدة اللي اليوم نشوفه في وقت هالجائحة الكبيرة، إلا أن الوطن هذا صامد بشعبه وصامد بقيادته، والحمد لله متصدر في محاربة هذا الفيروس اللي راح إن شاء الله ينزاح في القريب جدا. البحرين كلمة كبيرة ما أقدر أشرحها في دقيقة دقيقتين من هذا الفيلم، ولكن إيش كثر تستاهل البحرين؟ إيش كثر تستاهل البحرين؟ تستاهل أرواحنا. لا تنسون عندنا شهداء، لا تنسون عندنا أبطال ضحوا بحياتهم عشان هذا العلن. وهذه إذا تبغون شيء أعلن لكم في العلن، هذه أمنية وأمنيتي أني ودائما أطلب رب العالمين أنه ما يأخذني مريض على سرير، يأخذني وأنا في سبيل هذا الوطن، يأخذني وأنا أسعى لهذا الوطن والمواطن. الله يقدرني إن شاء الله على قد دعاي اللي هو فعلا اللي أنا أتمنى. المراد موضوع فينا خير، إحنا حقيقة فينا خير. الحملة هذه في لها أبعاد كثيرة. الدولة وانتم عارفين دعمت الاقتصاد الوطني، تسعى ليل نهار انها تدعم الاقتصاد الوطني عشان يبقى الاقتصاد منتعش وعشان تبقى الحياة ماشية. خذنا اجراءات جدا سليمة، نتصدر احنا دول العالم في حالات الشفاء، ونحاول قد ما نقدر ان احنا نمشي سير العمل. ولكن هل احنا بحاجة كذا 100,000؟ هل احنا بحاجة كذا مليون؟ لا، اللهم لك الحمد، جلالة الملك الله يطول عمره بأوامره نفذ المطلوب، ضخ مليارات اللي دعم الاقتصاد في مملكة البحرين. ولكن حملة فينا خير هذه تعطينا الفرصة، تعطينا الشرف المشاركة، إن عشان يوم الحساب أوقف وارفع راسي وأقول أنا ساهمت بلادي وساهمت يوم وقت الشدة. لأن النوع الثاني تعرفون شو بيسوي؟ بيدس راسه في الرمل، بيقول ما ظنيت ان هذا اليوم بيجي، ما ظنيت ان راح العالم يتشافى، وما ظنيت ان بلادي راح تتشافى. فاللهم لك الحمد، احنا نشوف اليوم ان احنا نمشي في خطى جدا سليمة. ولكن ان شاء الله ان تكون عندنا هذه الفرصة ان احنا نقدر نساهم باللي نقدر عليه. فارجوكم لا تاخذوني من منطلق المسؤول او منطلق الشخص يعني في عجلة أو مطبخ القرارات. أنا ناصر محب للبحرين في مكاني الرسمي أو في مكاني الخاص آسف، ما يلزمني لباسي الرسمي وإلى آخره، أتبرع أنا شخصيا بمليون دينار حق حملة فينا خير، قليل جدا قليل قليل، هذه قطرة في ماي باللي تستاهل مملكة البحرين. فهذا اللي أنا أقدر أحطه الآن، وعشان أحط الضغط المباشر على أصحاب الشركات، أصحاب المؤسسات، واللي كل واحد كان موجود في البلد وكلم الخير البلد، إنه يعيد حساباته ويقول هالسنين ذي كلها اللي أنا انتفعت من وراء البلد، شن هي خسائر شهر شهري، شن هي اليوم الإمكانية اللي أنا أقدر أسويها، وشن هو اللي أنا أقدر أقدمه للبلد. جانا اليوم اللي إحنا كنا نتكلم فيه، جانا اليوم اللي إحنا نقول شو أقدر أقدم للبلد. هذا هو اليوم، هذا هو اليوم اللي عقبه يوم الحساب. فأرجو من الجميع أن يعذرني على القليل اللي أنا قدمته لمملكة البحرين، وأتأمل إن شاء الله أتابع هذه الحملة وأشوف الأرقام هذه في ازدياد، وأشوف تكاتف. ترى مليون أو دينار كلها واحد، إذا مواطن قدم دينار واحد والله العظيم قسما بالله أن جلالة الملك وكل مسؤول في مملكة البحرين راح يشوفها بقدر 10 مليار. بس أبي أشوف اسمك، أبي أشوف اسمك أن أنت حطيت دينار واحد، عشان بكرة أفتخر وأقول البحرينيين تكاتفوا والبحرينيين وقفوا لبلدهم اللي كلوا من خيره وعاشوا في ذراه. فهذا هو اليوم اللي احنا ننتظره، هذه هي الوقفة اللي احنا نتأملها. واسمحوا لي اني اطولت عليكم، لان الموضوع اكبر بكثير من كم دقيقة اقدر اشرح لكم اياها، فالعذر والسموحة على التقصير مرة ثانية. لكن في ختام هذا الكلام اللي أقدر أقوله، أن إحنا فعلا فينا خير، والله العظيم فينا خير. هذه المحن اللي إحنا نمر فيها هذه امتحانات، لازم نشوف النهاية ونشوف العبرة بإذن الله بالناس اللي قاموا بواجبهم الوطني. وعشان ما أعيش أنا يوم من الأيام شايل هم أني أنا ما ساهمت، فأنا الحمد لله أبريت ذمتي، أتمنى من الجميع أن يبري ذمته وياي. وقفتكم مطلوبة اليوم، ونبي نروي قيادتنا الرشيدة شن هم مواطنينهم اللي وقفوا وياهم. ولا تنسون هالشي، الملك الله طول عمره باع كل شيء، وتعرفون الشرى، شرى صحتكم وسلامتكم. نقدر نقدم اللي نقدر نقدم اليوم، ما يوفي بهالشي هذا ولا يوفي بحق الله طول عمره. شكرا.
As part of the national efforts led by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince to mitigate the spread of the coronavirus and implementation of the directives of His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, RHF Secretary General Dr. Mustafa Sayed announced the launch of an online donation platform. RHF is now accepting donations from businesses and individuals in support of national efforts to mitigate the spread of COVID-19 via its website, accessible at www.rco.gov.bh. Dr. Sayed noted that the Is Good In Us campaign was launched in response to growing requests from individuals and entities across the private sector that wish to make monetary contributions to national efforts to mitigate the spread of the virus. The number of learners through the Ministry of Education's eGate increased within 1 month to over 477,000 users, all of whom benefited from the service. The Assistant Undersecretary for Planning and Information at the Ministry of Education, Nawal Al-Khatir, said that there is a lot of engagement on the part of students and their parents. She said that according to the available data, a service is being used by a wide section of the students' population. Al-Khatir added that the eGate includes over 408,000 pieces of educational materials from activities, exercises, discussion groups, and presentations, which were used by students as well as their teachers. The Ministry of Health, in coordination with the local authorities, continues to conduct random coronavirus tests throughout the kingdom in order to safeguard the well-being of citizens and residents. As part of the ongoing series of testing, mobile testing units collected random samples from citizens and residents in Ali, Al-Hid, Sanabis, Rufa'an, Al-Jufair, conducting a total of 850 tests for the virus. Throughout the process, the mobile testing units share information regarding COVID-19 and the ways in which infections can be avoided. This remains remains part of the ministry's mandate to ensure that all segments of society understand the threat of the virus and are contributing towards its mitigation by wearing a face mask in public settings, practicing social distancing, and washing their hands frequently and thoroughly, in addition to using an alcohol-based sanitizer. The ministry reminds citizens and residents of the importance of adhering to health recommendations that encourage all to stay at home when possible and to practice social distancing, particularly when practicing outdoor sports at social obligations at a place where goods and services are bought and sold in order to safeguard public health.